You guys got to let everybody know this message that I'm about to give you, because this is something that I just found out. It's beyond belief. This is regarding a House resolution that was initiated on May 1st of this year. 6666. That is not an exaggeration. I have no idea how this works, but this is what the actual House resolution number is, 6666. And I'm going to read you what that House resolution is. Please make sure that you pass this on to every single person that you know. I don't care whether you're in the United States or not, you got to get this information out. House Rule 66, or House Resolution 6666, is for COVID-19 Testing, Reaching, and Contacting Everyone Act. The acronym is TRACE Act. Again, TRACE Act stands for Testing, Reaching, and Contacting Everyone. It was introduced by Bobby Rush, who is a Democrat from the state of Illinois. And they have introduced this bill into the House, and they're going to roll this out from a testing standpoint in Ventura County, California, which happens to be where I'm at right now. Basically, this act is to allow individuals to come into your house, and if you've got a cough, or somebody in your family has a cough, or you have a fever, or anything that they determine that shows that you have COVID-19, regardless of whether you've been tested or not. They will also test people, but remember that testing already has been shown to be there to be a high rate of false positives. False positives meaning you don't have COVID-19, but the test shows it's false positive. It's showing up as positive, so they call it a false positive. We already know from the studies previously done, as far back as 1984, but as recently as 2018, that individuals that did not have COVID-19 or coronavirus, even in the cat model, cats that had never been exposed to coronavirus, tested positive if they had had a flu shot, if they had the trivalent or the covalent flu shot. And we don't know about the H1N1 shot, we don't know about the herpes zoster shot, the shingle shot. There's many other vaccines that people have gotten. We have no idea if people are going to be testing positive, have false positives based upon those tests. So the point is that the chance of them testing someone and them being positive is pretty doggone high, even if the person doesn't have COVID-19. But they're going to use that to pull you or your loved ones, especially your children, away under pretense of public safety. They're going to say that your child has to be removed from you because you have COVID-19, and so to protect your child, we're going to take that child, or we're going to take your grandmother or your father or you and put you into quarantine. This is a load of rubbish, because if you're in your home isolated, who are you going to expose? All right? And if they're going to try to take you away from your family, the chances of you having infected your family, even if you did really have COVID-19, is about 99.9%. So this is a bunch of BS. They're using this as an attempt to further divide us as individuals. They divided us from our friends, from our social circles. Now they're dividing us from our own family units. This is the most ominous sign so far that we've seen. I want you to all wake up. I want you to pass this information on. I want you to tell every single person that you know what's happening. If you're not in the United States, I don't care. It's coming to your country as well. And if you're in the United States, you need to contact your representatives. Right now, if you go to askdrbutard.com/ask, right underneath my image, you'll see that link. Go to that website, follow the information that it's asking, enter that information in, and then you're going to be taken to a page. The first one is a petition. It's a petition about censorship against media, that mainstream media has right now, as well as social platforms. Sign that petition. Second thing is a website, or is a link that'll take you to allow you to send any letter that you want to people to elected officials on the municipal level, on the state level, and on the federal level, and tell them that you violently oppose HR 6666. Every single person needs to do that right now. You don't have to even know your House members or your representatives or your governor or your mayor. You don't have to have any information. That link that we have, all you do is type in your name, your email address, and then click on your zip code, and it will automatically find your elected officials, and with one letter, you'll get it to every single person. It's actually going to work for Australia, and it's also going to work, I think Australia, UK, and Canada, I think, is coming down the pipeline. Right now, it may only be working for the U.S., but our plan is within the next couple of days, it will work for elected officials in Australia, in Canada, in the U.K., and in the U.S. For right now, it's in the U.S. So write down that you oppose H.R. 6666, the TRACE Act, the Testing, Reaching, and Contacting Everyone Act. I want to now read you a quote from a Supreme Court justice, and remember this. James Agler Fee said, "The privilege against self-incrimination, which is basically to ensure your freedom," and we're talking about the exact same thing here, to ensure your freedom, "is neither accorded to the passive resistant nor the person who is ignorant of his rights, nor to one indifferent thereto. It is a fighting clause. Its benefits can be retained only by sustained combat. It cannot be retained by attorney or solicitor. It is valid only when insisted upon by a belligerent claimant in person. The one who is persuaded by honeyed words or moral suasion to testify or produce, rather than to make a last-ditch stand to ensure their own freedom, simply loses the protection. He must refuse to answer or produce, and against all odds." Now, it goes on. You guys can look up the quote yourself. Judge James Agler Fee, a Supreme Court justice. I want you to remember that this is how it all begins. Do not sit still. Let everyone in your social network know. Pass this on, pay it forward, because tomorrow it could be your family, in your county, in your state, this is going to happen. If you're in Ventura County, California right now, you need to do something today, because if you don't, tomorrow it's going to be your child or your parent or your spouse that's going to be removed. It's going to be your brother or your sister. So you need to do something right now.